In this screencast, we're going to customize viewlets in Plone 3. The method that you need to adopt depends on what customization you need to make, either to the content and or the position of the viewlet. The simplest kind of customization is to add some static text to an existing viewlet. For example, let's say that I wanted to add the name of my group to the personal bar. We can do this via portal view customizations in the ZMI. There it is. We find the viewlet we want, the personal bar, we click on its name, and then we click the Customize button. This gives us a ZMI-based copy of the viewlet to which we can add our customizations. So I add the text which I want to add, in this case the name of our group. Hit the Save button, and now that text should be incorporated in the relevant viewlet. There it is. If we want to get rid of viewlet customizations we've just made, we go back to Portal View Customizations in the ZMI, click on the Contents tab. There is the viewlet we just customized. Click the box next to it and click Delete. So very simple customizations to viewlet content can be made using Portal View Customizations in the ZMI. You can also hide a viewlet or change its position to a limited extent by pointing and clicking in the Plone interface. To do this, we log into the site as a manager and append @ManageViewlets to the end of the URL. This brings up a screen that shows us all the viewlets in the body section of the page. There's the site actions viewlet, the search box viewlet, the logo viewlet, and so on. You'll notice that each viewlet is contained in a viewlet manager. We can move viewlets around relative to other viewlets by clicking the little arrows. So I'm going to move the Plone personal bar to the top of the page by clicking the up arrow. There it goes. Now if I refresh my site, I see that the personal bar has moved up. Or I can hide the personal bar completely by clicking the word hide. It's gone. So far we've talked about very simple changes to viewlet content and position. But what if we want to do something more complicated? For instance, what if we want to move our personal bar viewlet to the footer? And what if we want to add something complicated to it, for example, today's date and time, or the number of days remaining until Christmas? For that, we need to make our own add-on product on the file system. Here, I have a theme product made using Paster. At the moment, it's empty. I've made no customizations, except one change to a style sheet, so that the personal bar will turn yellow when I install the product. So here's the product available to install. I'm using the ZMI Quick Installer to install it. There it is. Just to check that the product's working, yes, the personal bar has turned yellow. Now we want to move the personal bar to the footer. We can't do that using the @ManageViewlets interface because this interface doesn't allow us to move viewlets between viewlet managers. Instead, we need to change two files in our file system product. First, we need to register the viewlet for the viewlet manager to which we'd like to move it. We do this by changing the configure.zcml file in our product's browser folder. To take a look at how to register a viewlet, we can go and see how Plone does it. The relevant code is in an egg called Plone app layout. It's in the viewlets folder in that egg, again in a configure.zcml file. Here, I've copied that code to the configure.zcml folder of my theme product, and I've added one more line to it. Let's take a look at the code. The registration specifies the name of the viewlet. Here it's the standard Plone personal bar viewlet, so the name is Plone personal bar, as it was in Plone's original registration for this viewlet. But we want to specify a different manager. We want to specify the footer. So we specify the manager using the interface for the relevant viewlet manager. if we don't know exactly what that interface is, we can always check by going to our site, going to the at manage viewlets screen, and the viewlet manager details are given both by name and by interface. There's the interface, Plone app layout viewlets interfaces, iPortal footer. The next two lines in the viewlet registration ZCML, class and permission, are exactly the same as the original registration for this viewlet in the default Plone site. We'll come back to these two lines later. The final line is one I added. It specifies a layer. Essentially, this line says, take effect only when our theme product is installed. It does this by pointing at an interface which is specific to our theme. So we've now registered Plone's personal bar viewlet as being available to the footer. Sadly, that's not all we have to do to make it show up in exactly the right place. If we uninstall and reinstall our product after changing the ZCML, and remember we have to restart Zope because we changed ZCML to make Zope see the changes, we do indeed see that the viewlet now appears in the footer. But we still have the original personal bar appearing in the header, and the position of this viewlet in the footer may not be exactly where we want it to be. So we need to make some more changes to our theme product. Specifically, we need to change the viewlets.xml file in the default installation profile. So that's profiles, default, viewlets.xml. So the first thing we want to do is to hide the personal bar viewlet that came with Plone. We do that by using the hidden tag. We specify the manager where we want to hide the viewlet, we give the name of the viewlet, and we also say what skin that this change applies in. We can now uninstall and reinstall our product, and we should see that the change takes effect. We don't need to restart Zope this time because the only change we've made is to the XML, and that doesn't require a restart for Zope to detect it. Okay, we uninstalled, we reinstalled, and as we intended, the personal bar viewlet has disappeared from the header. Now let's say that in the footer we want the personal bar viewlet to appear above the rest of the footer. How do we do that? Well, the answer is we use XML again. We put in a different tag this time, an order tag. Again, we specify the viewlet manager and the name of the skin in which this change is to take place and the name of the viewlet, the personal bar. And this time we specify where it has to appear. We can either insert it before or insert it after another viewlet. Again, we uninstall and reinstall our product. When we refresh our site, we indeed see that our viewlet has moved in the footer. So far, we've registered the Plone personal bar viewlet for the footer, put it in the place we want relative to other viewlets, and hidden it in the portal top. Now, let's say that we want to add another viewlet to the footer. How do we do that?